My responsibility as the COO, I take care of ensuring that we make great quality products. I ensure that we move the products from our factories to our warehouses and onwards to our customers' residences or the residences or the warehouses of our distributors, and also ensure that we keep the entire process running extremely smooth and seamlessly. It is indeed my privilege to be here because I actually share a very special connect with Hyderabad. Though I'm currently based out of Bangalore, I spent the best part of my childhood, including my college days, very much in Hyderabad, and I graduated out of here before I moved on to work in various parts of the country. I'm actually extremely excited to be here to talk about a few new product launches that we're going to be doing, and without any further ado, let me get started with that. But first, it is my delight to tell you that Xiaomi has retained its position as the number one smartphone brand in India for the fourth consecutive quarter, starting the third quarter of 2017, all the way up to the most recent quarter, which is Q2 of 2018. We have retained our market leadership with a market share of 29.7%, but more importantly, in the online segment, we have a dominant position. We have the leadership position there for seven consecutive quarters with a market share of 55.6%. Just to get that dimensioned, what this means is if you were to add the online sale of all other smartphone brands together, it'll still be lesser than what Xiaomi sells online in India in any given quarter. When you're doing such large quantum of sale, when there are so many users of Xiaomi phones, of course, it places a whole lot of responsibility on us. We understand that our Xiaomi phone users would need us to help them, support them, service their phones in case something goes wrong. And this is something that we have invested behind, we focus on, and have built out a huge network of after-sales centers. I'm delighted to tell you that today, with over 1,000 service centers for mobile phones in India, in fact, 1,000 service centers being launched in Hyderabad exactly 3 months ago, Xiaomi has been rated not just number one in sales, but it is also number one in after-sales service as certified by RedQuanta, which is a third-party market research agency. And the input of this comes clearly from customers from a field survey. And what's more exciting is we score extremely highly on all the things that matter most to customers when it comes to after-sales service, be it infrastructure, be it understanding and identifying the right issue, resolving the issue, and resolving it in the first contact so that the customer doesn't have to keep coming back to the service center again and again. Moving on, the Redmi series is a series of phones that we've had in India for a few years now, which has garnered an enormous user base and an enormous fan base. We keep talking to our customers, and they tell us how this is their favorite series for many, many years to come. In fact, four out of the top five selling smartphones in India are all from the Redmi series: the Redmi 5A, the Redmi Note 5 Pro, the Redmi Note 5, and the Redmi 5. All these put together account for 26% of all smartphone shipments in Q2 of 2018. And with a fan base like this, which is growing, we believe we should do a lot more to justify the love that our users and fans give us. And towards this, we try to take it one step further. Today, it is my pleasure and privilege to launch here in Hyderabad, along with the simultaneous national launch in Delhi, three new phones in the Redmi series, which are launched specifically grounds up, taking feedback from our Redmi users. Let's take a quick look at what these three are. Number one, we have the Redmi 6A, which is primarily meant for people for whom this would be their first smartphone, essentially packing a lot of bang for the buck. Then we have the Redmi 6, which brings all the goodness of a dual camera in a manner that's accessible to a large number of people. And then, of course, we have our power users. And for them, we bring today the Redmi 6 Pro. Now, let's get started with the first one. The Redmi 6A, which is a worthy successor to the super successful Redmi 5A phone. Redmi 5A has been immensely successful ever since it launched about 7 months ago. It's been the top-selling smartphone in India, has garnered many, many faithful users, and it's been very affectionately accepted and considered as the Desh Ka smartphone. In fact, there are many feature phone users for whom this is their first upgrade. When you move from a feature phone into a smartphone, the Redmi 5A is primarily the first in their consideration set. And we have many heartwarming stories of Redmi users and Mi fans who have written to us, posted on our community on what an impact has Redmi phones meant for them. And here you have a user, Saurav, who said he's purchased and gifted a Redmi 5A phone to his father. And he said, look, it changed his life. It brought a whole new smartphone experience to the family, and they feel so much more empowered. But this is just one of the so many stories that we hear from our fans all the time. Now, while this is the most popular smartphone in India, I'm sure a lot of you are also aware that the Redmi 5A is the best-selling Android smartphone in the world for two quarters, quarter one of 2018 and quarter two of 2018. So it's not just popular in India, but it is also the best-selling smartphone all over the world. And this phone has sold 3 million units in India in the last quarter, which is Q2 of 2018. Now, building on this huge success, we want to make the nation's most loved smartphone, the Redmi 5A, even better, which is why today we bring to you Redmi 6A, Desh Ka Naya smartphone. Now, let's talk about what Redmi 6A has in store. First, we ensure that this has got all-round upgrades everywhere on the things that matter to the customer, on design, on performance, on camera. Let's spend some time on each of these, starting with design. First up, a nice large 18:9 aspect ratio, 5.45-inch full screen display. The beauty of the 8.9 aspect ratio is that it actually packs in a lot more screen for the same size as a typical smartphone, but it's not just the aspect ratio. We've actually increased the screen size from the 5-inch earlier in the Redmi 5A to the 5.45-inch, and all of this effectively results in 10% more display space for our customers, and for them, if this is their first smartphone, that just results in such a better experience. On the backside, we have this brilliant brushed metal finish, which a lot of our users have told us that they really love, and a nice, sleek arc design, which feels very, very nice and light to hold and handle. In fact, you should try this out in the experience center and give us feedback on how does the phone actually feel in the hand. We bring this in four colors, black, gold, rose gold, and blue. But design is just one part. What actually matters is also performance, and let's talk a little bit about performance here. And this is something that actually matters to a lot of users, especially those upgrading from a feature phone, because they have very, very high expectations from a smartphone. In the Redmi 6A, we have packed in a Helio A22 12 nanometer quad-core processor with a clock speed up to 2 gigahertz. So what's this 12 nanometer quad-core all about? And it's a lot about the way transistors are designed. Right? If you look at basic electronics, smaller is always better. And therefore, the smaller the size of the chipset, smaller the size of the channel, the more power you can pack into it, lesser is the entire power consumption. So the 12 nanometer FinFET technology gives you better power efficiency, better thermal performance, and better SoC performance. Let me spend a couple of minutes in explaining to you the beauty of this entire 12 nanometer FinFET technology. Now, this is a traditional transistor, right? With a 28 nanometer channel, there is current flowing across here, and that's how you communicate all the ones and zeros, right? That's how transistors operate. So every time this channel, if this gate is on, that means there is a one flowing. Every time it's off, that means it's a zero, and that's how computers work, and that's how mobile phones work. But in such a technology, there is always some power leakage because this is exposed, because the gate is exposed. And when power leaks, what does that mean? It means that battery performance suffers, which means there is a drag on the overall performance. The beauty of the 12 nanometer FinFET technology is that this channel, which is meant to communicate, actually gets translated into a three-dimensional fin, which means the gate, which is used for switching, covers the channel from three dimensions, minimizing the entire power loss, optimizing performance, and hence delivering significantly longer battery life with the 12 nanometer FinFET technology with the 3D structure. And we have seen this. We have seen this reflect in superb battery performance. For the same 3000 mAh battery capacity, you have 4G talk time, which is up by 41%. You have video playback, which is up by 34%. Across the board, on all things that matter to the customer when it comes to battery, in regular use cases, with the 12 nanometer FinFET technology, the A22 Helio processor, the Redmi 6A delivers substantially better performance. The Redmi 6A is the only smartphone in the segment with this unique 12 nanometer FinFET technology, and it's not just that. It is the only smartphone in the segment with a clock speed of up to 2 gigahertz, which delivers all the performance requirements that our users would have, which reflects in a 39% increase in the system on chip performance scores at a battery consumption that's almost half of what was there earlier, which is perhaps what our users need when they're buying their first smartphone. In summary, the Redmi 6A is more powerful and faster than ever across the AnTuTu score. The AnTuTu score is 15% better than what the Redmi 5A delivered. Quad cores, up to 2 gigahertz clock speed, the 12 nanometer FinFET, and of course, significantly better power efficiency with the Redmi 6A. The Redmi 6A comes with AI facial unlock with the AI face detection technology to ensure that safety and security of the phone is maintained at all point of time. And the coolest part about the Redmi 6A and the facial unlock to me is just raise and wake. All you do is raise the phone, put it in front of your face, facial unlock happens, and boom, you're onto your home screen and you can start using your phone. No fiddling with pin and patterns and so on and so forth. It just makes it so much more easier. And it's not just facial unlock. There are those who would pair their phone with their Mi Fit Band, which helps you unlock the phone. And we also can leave the phone unlocked with our smart unlock feature in a trusted network or trusted Bluetooth zone. The phone, the Redmi 6A phone, comes with a dual nano SIM slot and a dedicated micro SD card slot, which can take expandable memory up to 256 GB for all the movies and music that our users want to store. And it's got dual VoLTE with dual standby. Now, there are many phones out there in the market that support dual VoLTE, but both of them cannot be active at any point of time. Effectively, what dual VoLTE and dual standby means is if you have two 4G VoLTE SIM cards on your phone, you will be able to receive calls on both at any point of time. Also, use one for calling and use one for data at the same point of time. This is something that our users told us they wanted, and here we have built it into the phone. The Redmi 6A comes with MIUI 9.6 based on Android Oreo 8.1 out of the box, with MIUI 10 coming soon. That was on performance, but I'm sure a lot of people also want to know about the camera. The Redmi 6A camera is no slouch. It has a 13 megapixel camera, rear camera, with face detection autofocus, which effectively helps render extremely clear images, sharp images with great color reproduction. And here's an example. You could see the vibrant reds and yellows and blues that come, along with the great detailing in the t-shirt with a picture taken with a 6A. Another image, you could see the skin tone, the clarity in the hair strands standing out against the brick wall. Beautiful rendition, great color range coming out of the picture taken with the Redmi 6A. The Redmi 6A also very excitingly comes with electronic image stabilization for video shooting, eliminating unwanted movement and shakes. If you actually go and check in the market, most phones in the 15,000 rupee plus price range would be the ones offering EIS. Here in the Redmi 6A, which we believe is Desh ka naya smartphone, we are offering electronic image stabilization. Up in the front, we have the AI selfie camera, which has AI portrait and AI beautify modes based on an AI computing engine and deep learning algorithms. Essentially, what that means is using our algorithms, we are able to clearly distinguish between the person who's taking the selfie and the background, which results in us creating wonderful selfie portraits like this. Look at the crispness of the image in the front, how clearly the hairs stand out, and the nicely blurred background. I mean, these kind of selfies are just wonderful to see, and I'm sure people would love taking selfies using Redmi 6A, which is Desh Khanna's smartphone. We've also built in AI Beautify 4.0. In very simple terms, this engine detects various skin types, detects your facial patterns, and works like a virtual makeup that works all day long, just using software. A good example, flawless features, blemishless features, great color reproduction of the orange here. These are the kind of selfies I'm sure people want to shoot for themselves. To sum up, Redmi 6A, Desh Khanna's smartphone, 18:9, 5.45-inch full-screen display, the 12-nanometer FinFET processor, 2 gigahertz clock speed, the 13-megapixel camera with PDAF, AI selfie camera, face unlock, and of course, dual VoLTE with dual standby. We worked really, really hard at this, and we've ensured that the 6A is an all-round upgrade across design, across performance, and across camera over the Redmi 5A. Especially, you'll see the big differences here on the processor, as well as the dual VoLTE features and a bunch of other features that our users have often been wanting, including a significant improvement in battery performance from 14.5 hours 4G talk time to 20.5 hours 4G talk time. That is what the Redmi 6A brings. Moving on, comparing this with some of the other popular smartphones, you could see that the Redmi 6A would outscore and outclass similar players in this price range, which would be J2 and Honor 7S, on all the features that matter, processor, camera, etc. So that was Redmi 6A, what we are affectionately calling Desh Khanna's smartphone, and I'm sure our users would wholeheartedly adopt it as their Naya smartphone. Moving on to the second big launch of this afternoon, which is Redmi 6, dual camera, octa-core speed. Let's talk about this in a little bit more detail, starting with the design. The Redmi 6, again, offers an 18:9, 5.45-inch full-screen display with HD Plus resolution, a really nice and sleek rush metal finish, the arc display, which makes it feel very natural, very cool, very light, very sleek in the hand, and comes in four exciting colors, black, gold, rose gold, and definitely my favorite, the blue. Now let's get to the camera and start with some comparison first. Let's look at what others in the similar segment have to offer. The best that you can see there is a 13-megapixel single-lens camera with a pixel size of 1.12 microns. Now let's see what we have in store with Redmi 6. With the Redmi 6, extremely excited to state that we have packed in a 12+5-megapixel dual camera in the rear with a massive 1.25 micron pixel size. Now you might ask me, so what's the big deal with 1.25 microns? And let's spend a minute on that. In photography, right, light is what matters. The larger your pixel size, the larger is your ability to take in light. And of course, from 1.12 to 1.25, you could see that the light intake increases by 20%. And when you have more light, you can perform admirably well in low light conditions, ensure great clarity and crispness of the image, ensure great color reproduction, and ensure fantastic contrast to your images. And that's exactly what the Redmi 6 helps deliver with its massive 1.25 micron pixel. And this is an image that showcases the dynamic range of the Redmi 6. And just to showcase a few examples here, if you can see the sunlit portion coming around very, very clearly, as well as the dark interiors and the detailing in the table also coming out clearly, it's not very easy for ordinary cameras to deliver this kind of dynamic range and clarity in an image. And the Redmi 6 also performs remarkably well in low light conditions. This, of course, is shot at night close to dusk, and you can see how nicely the details have got laid out here. The Redmi 6 also comes with an AI portrait mode, which uses our AI-powered semantic segmentation engine. What semantic segmentation effectively does it helps very clearly distinguish between the edges so that the background can get blurred and the foreground remains extremely sharp, neat and clean. You can see some of the detailing here in the air, how clean these shoulders have got laid out, while all of the background is clearly laid out. That is what the AI portrait mode helps accomplish. Another wonderful representation here, I'd again quote the example of the strands of hair standing out clearly and all the background blurring, which helps the model in the front stand out loud, clear, crisp, literally popping out in this image. And oh, by the way, it also works on men, not just women. Moving on, the Redmi 6 also possesses electronic image stabilization to ensure that your videos don't shake. And up front, we have an AI selfie camera, again with AI portrait and AI beautify features. Moving on to its performance, which is what matters to most people, and we want to ensure that we deliver great performance to our users without sacrificing battery life, because you know that trade-off is not worth it. And let's see how we have gone about doing that. Starting with a quick comparison of other players in the similar segment, frankly, the best that we've got out there is maybe a 14 nanometer node and a 1.4 or a 1.8 gigahertz sort of a solution for most players, including the Samsung J4, the Honor 7C, and so on. Super delighted, super excited to announce that in the Redmi 6, we have a Helio P22 processor with a 12 nanometer octa-core processor with a clock speed up to 2 gigahertz. We've learned a little bit earlier that with the 12 nanometer FinFET architecture, smaller is always better. You get great battery and power efficiency, much better thermal performance, and superlative system-on-chip performance. The Redmi 6 is the only smartphone in its segment with a 12 nanometer octa-core processor. And you might ask me, so what's the big deal with octa-core? How is octa-core substantially better than quad-core? Well, there are many reasons. The most important one is intelligent task allocation. The way this works is, under normal circumstances, you have the 1.5 gigahertz, the four cores. When you're browsing, when you're chatting, when you're looking at an image, these are the ones that are doing all the hard work. But if you're doing video editing, if you're playing an intensive game which requires a lot of graphics and processing, that's when the 2 gigahertz cores come in. Now, a 2 gigahertz core always consumes more power than a 1.5 gigahertz. So very smartly, the chip manages to allocate power, reserve power when required the most, as opposed to cranking at full throttle all the time. And what does that result in? Better power efficiency, and therefore a much longer battery life. We've seen that the system-on-chip performance is 30% better than our previous variants, Redmi 5 and Redmi 4, at almost half the power consumption as compared to our previous model, all courtesy our Helio P22 12 nanometer octa-core processor clocking up to 2 gigahertz. In summary, we have 12 nanometers, octa-core, 2 gigahertz clock speed, and the most important part there, let me not forget, is intelligent task allocation. A quick comparison of how this compares against all the other similar models in the same segment. Very clearly, the Redmi 6 stands out in terms of number of cores, the clock speed, as well as the node, which results in much better battery performance and efficiency. What that results in from a battery perspective is, even with a 3000 mAh battery, we can deliver full day performance that powers through the day, a solid 29 hours of talk time, and a good 9 days standby, all courtesy very, very smart power management on the processor. A full day plus of call time and 9 days of standby is what this chipset and the 3000 mAh battery delivered. And it's not just those numbers. We looked at all the common use cases and how is this better than the previous Redmi 5, be it calling time, be it music playback, be it video playback, 11% better, 21% better, 20% better. So in all ways, the Redmi 6 is a significant bump up and an upgrade over the Redmi 5, and I'm hoping our users will truly love this. From a security perspective, the Redmi 6 not only features an AI facial unlock, but also has a fingerprint sensor. So we're just giving more choices, more options for our users to decide how they want to secure and unlock their phone. You also have the option of unlocking the phone using your Mi Fit band, as well as using smart unlock, especially in a trusted network or a Bluetooth zone. The phone comes with a dual nano SIM slot with a dedicated micro SD slot for expandable memory. Also comes with dual VoLTE and dual standby. Ships with MIUI 9.6 out of the box, with MIUI 10 coming soon. In summary, here we have Redmi 6, dual camera, octa-core speed, 12 plus 5 megapixel rear camera with, most importantly, a 1.25 micron pixel size, 20% more light, much better photo quality, the 12 nanometer FinFET technology clocking up to 2 gigahertz, the 18:9 full screen display, AI selfie camera with AI portrait and beautify modes, face unlock, and finally dual VoLTE, all of which results in a complete all-round upgrade, again, across design, performance, and camera over the immensely successful Redmi 5. So that's Redmi 6, dual camera, and octa-core speed. Now moving in to what could perhaps be the highlight of the afternoon. The Redmi 6 Pro. Now we get it, we've spoken to our fans. The Redmi 5 was a great phone. By all indications, the Redmi 6, looking at how wonderful an all-ground upgrade it is over the Redmi 5, I'm sure all of our fans love it. But there are many users who told us, look, we want more. We want a game with it. We want long performance. We want the battery to last much longer. And we call them power users, right? And we want to ensure that we have the right product proposition just for them. And it is for them that we've made this device, the Redmi 6 Pro. Dual camera with a 2-day battery. Let's talk a little bit more about this phone. Firstly, the design. And this is where the things get really interesting. Firstly, a 19:9 full screen display, 5.84 inch full HD plus with, on popular demand, a notch on top. I'm sure there are a lot of our users out there who like notches, and there are those who don't. There are the purists who don't want a notch. So we said we need to solve for them too. And we did. What you see there is a notch. We have a simple setting which can turn the notch off for those who don't want a notch. And it works not just on the phone, but it also works on humans. Just kidding. And that's Raghu, our online sales head. But moving on to the back of the phone, the Redmi 6 Pro has this beautiful aluminum body with nice rounded edges at the back, and it just feels so nice to hold in your hand. In fact, when we went about thinking of designing it, we said, look, we just don't want a phone that feels good in your hand. It should be worth showing off. I mean, it should be something that others look at and say, hey, what phone is that? I'd love to get something like that. And that's the piece of beauty that we have created with the Redmi 6 with the Redmi 6 Pro. Comes in multiple colors. You just saw black. There is gold. There is this beautiful blue, which I really love. But a lot of users out there actually desire and covet this fantastic red, this ravishing red model, which we are seeing on the screen there. So four colors in all. You have black, you have gold, you have blue, and you have the red. Let me take you through a quick video for the phone. Cool, isn't it? There's perhaps one thing that you notice there. This has a dual rear camera too, and we call it an AI dual rear camera, and let me talk a little bit more about that. So two lenses there, one a 12 megapixel primary lens with a Sony sensor, again 1.25 micron pixels, and a 5 megapixel secondary camera with a Samsung sensor. And we've covered this before, larger the sensor, larger the pixel size, 20% higher light intake, which means greater performance across various light conditions, excellent color reproduction, excellent contrast, and excellent dynamic range. And we see this in the performance of the Redmi 6 Pro. Performs extremely well on across low, medium, and high light conditions, including indoor and outdoor. It's got this really nice AI portrait mode, which works with our AI semantic segmentation engine. Very smart, very accurate edge detection, and I'll kind of take you through an example of how that works. Here are three, like the same picture of the same lady taken across three phones. You have the Redmi 6 Pro in the middle, you have the Samsung J6, and you have the Oppo A5. And let me call out a few differences. One, the Samsung J6 doesn't have a portrait mode. It does not blur. Redmi 6 Pro provides the best performance in its class, Snapdragon 625, and that massive 4000 mAh battery, giving two-day battery life. The 6 Pro also comes with MIUI 9.6 based on Android Oreo 8.1 out of the box, with MIUI 10 coming soon. Multiple ways to secure your phone, fingerprint, face unlock, AI face unlock, unlocking with the Mi Band, as well as smart unlock. Has a 2+1 card slot, dual nano SIM, and a dedicated micro SD slot. And it comes with this nice, sleek, tight-fitting, beautiful-looking, ultra-slim case out of the box. A lot of our users have told us that, hey, we just need a better way of securing it. I've ordered the phone, the accessory comes much later, and I'm worried my phone would get damaged. So we packed this ultra-slim case into the box. So there you have, ladies and gentlemen, the Redmi 6 Pro, dual camera with a two-day battery, 12+5 megapixel AI dual camera, 1.25 microns, the Snapdragon 625 octa-core processor, and a beautiful 19:9 full-screen display with a notch, 5.84 inch, and most importantly, a massive 4000 mAh battery that gives two-day battery life. So while I've spoken about a bunch of these products, I thought it's important for me to cover another important angle of what Xiaomi in India stands for, and that's quality. We have millions of users who trust us, and we procure our components from the best-in-class suppliers. But most importantly, we are huge believers and proponents in the Make in India program. For the past 3 years, we have taken on Make in India as a key strategic initiative. All Redmi phones sold in India are made in India. We have 6 factories across 3 locations. We've gone one step further. We also manufacture PCBAs, the printed circuit boards, which is the main chip, which is basically the heart of the phone. That is also manufactured locally here in India. And as a brand dedicated to Make in India, we hope to convert India into a global manufacturing hub. And it's not just manufacturing, we also take quality and making things work in Indian conditions very, very seriously. And one simple example of how we did that is adding this thing called the dual pyrolytic graphic sheet, or graphite sheet. And you might ask me, so what's the big deal? How does this work? Effectively, what this does is when you add those two graphite sheets in the back of the phone, the surface temperature of the phone decreases by 2 degrees. Again, you might ask me, what's the big deal? 2 degrees can't mean much. 2 degrees doesn't mean much for you and me. But on a phone, when it comes to power efficiency of the chipset and battery performance, 2 degrees makes all the difference. Therefore, by adding, especially given our environmental conditions, where our summer heat is much higher, this results in significantly better performance and longer battery life. And it's not just this. We conduct at the design stage over 4,000 hardware and software tests to put our phones through the rough and tumble to ensure that it meets all regular, normal, as well as sometimes extreme usage conditions be it drop test, be it headphone jack test, be it temperature and humidity checks, and so on and so forth. So we shot a video to kind of demonstrate and bring some of this to life. I would advise and caution, please do not try this at home. We're doing this so that you don't have to. Moving on to something that a lot of us would be interested in, price. But before we get to the pricing details for the individual models, I just wanted to spend some time setting a very important context. And that's something which is impacting all of us. It's impacting the economy. And that's the fluctuation in the rupee dollar rates. The rupee to the dollar is about 71 rupees today. And a few months ago, it was in the mid-60s. There's been a significant depreciation in the rupee. And needless to say, it impacts us at Xiaomi, it impacts the entire industry. And we need to be very, very mindful and acknowledge that that's happening. At Xiaomi, we have this core belief that we have to deliver great specs with fantastic quality at truly honest pricing. So let's see what that means for the individual pricing of our products. First, the Redmi 6A, as we called out earlier, Desh Kanaya smartphone, the 5.45-inch 18:9 display, a 13-megapixel rear camera with PDAF, which is an all-round upgrade across design, performance, and camera over the Redmi 5A. If I were to benchmark the Redmi 6A with other popular models in the same segment, being the Samsung J2, the Honor 7S, you can see the price ranges as much as about 8,000 rupees. So what do we have? The Redmi 6A comes in two variants, the first of which is a 2GB plus 62GB variant, which we are launching at 5999. I need to mention that this is an introductory price for the next couple of months, looking at the context that I said a little bit earlier on the rupee dollar fluctuations. If the dollar stays at 71 or depreciates further, then we might have to reconsider some of this pricing, because it is unsustainable to continue doing this over a long period of time given the way the exchange rates are trending. But for the next couple of months, we have this introductory price, a super attractive price of 5999 for the 2 plus 16 variant of Redmi 6A Desh Kanaya smartphone. The next variant in the Redmi 6A is the 2 plus 32GB variant, which starts at 6999, again an introductory price for the next couple of months. The first sale for the Redmi 6A would start at 12 noon on the 19th of September, and this would be available on me.com and amazon.in, to be followed shortly offline in our Mi Home stores and Mi Preferred Partners. So the first sale is on 12 noon, 19th of September. That was Redmi 6A. Moving on to Redmi 6. Like we discussed earlier, dual camera, octa-core speed, 12 plus 5 megapixel rear camera, the Helio P22 octa-core processor, 12 nanometer FinFET technology, 5.45-inch HD plus display, and with the fingerprint sensor and AI face unlock, which, again, significant all-round upgrade over the Redmi 5. Benchmarking this with other players in a similar segment, be it the Samsung J4, the Honor 7C, the Moto G6 Play, you can see just from a feature perspective, significantly outclasses everybody, be it screen size, the fact that it's got a dual rear camera with AI portrait mode, dual world view, and the price benchmark that we have is anywhere between 10,000 to 12,000. The Redmi 6 comes in two variants, 3GB plus 32GB. selling at 799 introductory price for the next couple of months, like we mentioned earlier, depending on how the rupee dollar exchange rate pans out. At some point of time, we will have to reevaluate this pricing. And for the 3GB plus 64GB variant, a price of 9499 introductory for the next couple of months. The first sale for the Redmi 6 will occur at 12 noon on the 10th of September 2018, will be available on Mi.com and Flipkart online, to be followed shortly offline in our Mi homes as well as Mi preferred partners. To make this even more attractive, the Redmi 6 has a first sale offer in partnership with HDFC Bank, where the customer would get rupees 500 off if he or she chooses to pay with debit or credit cards or does an EMI transaction, effectively bringing the price down by another 500 bucks. Thirdly, coming to the Redmi 6 Pro, dual camera, two-day battery. We spoke about 12 plus 5 megapixel AI dual camera, the massive 4000 mAh battery, Qualcomm Snapdragon 625, and that beautiful 19:9 full screen 5.84 inch display with that notch which you can turn off if you don't like it. Comes with two variants, 3GB, 32GB, 4GB, 64GB, and when I benchmark with other players in the same segment, be it the Samsung J6, the Oppo A5, you can look at price point varying from 13,000 rupees to 16,000 rupees. So let's take a look at what the pricing for Redmi 6 Pro would be. The 3GB plus 32GB variant sells at 10,999, which is an astounding price for such a beautiful phone, packed with a whole host of features and a two-day battery life for all our power users. I'm sure our power users will truly love this price. And for the other variant, which is the 4 plus 64GB model, 12,999 is what the retailing price is. The first sale for Redmi 6 Pro will happen at 12 noon on the 11th of September on Mi.com and Amazon.in, will shortly be followed and be available offline in our Mi homes and our Mi preferred partners. The 500 rupee off HDFC offer is also extended to the Redmi 6 Pro. For the first sale, customers using debit or credit cards or EMI transactions with HDFC Bank, both on Mi.com and Amazon, would get rupees 500 off. That brings me to the close. We have three new launches today. Redmi 6A, Deshkanaya smartphone, Redmi 6, dual camera, octa-core speed, and finally the Redmi 6 Pro, dual camera with two-day battery. We'll now get into a photo op, please.
Hi, my name is Murali Krishnan, and I'm the Chief Operating Officer of Xiaomi in India. And I'm here today to announce the launch of three new exciting devices in our Redmi range. Firstly, the Redmi 6A, which possesses a 12 nanometer quad-core processor, which brings great power and performance to entry-level smartphone users. We affectionately like to call this Deshkanaya smartphone, and this phone starts retailing at a price of 5,999. The second launch that we have today is the Redmi 6, which has dual camera with octa-core speed, powered by a Helio P22 octa-core processor with 12 nanometer FinFET technology again, has a 12 plus 5 megapixel rear camera, which can produce great images. And this starts retailing at 7,499. And finally, we have the Redmi 6 Pro with a wonderful aluminum body, 19:9, 5.84 inch screen. It comes with a notch and a beautiful rear camera with 12 plus 5 megapixels and a pixel size of 1.2 microns. And this starts retailing at 10,999. The Redmi 6A will have its first sale on the 19th of September at 12 noon. The Redmi 6 will start on the 10th of September, and the Redmi 6 Pro on the 11th of September. All three models will be available both online and offline. The Redmi 6A and Redmi 6 Pro will be available on Mi.com and Amazon.in with offline channels, which is Mi Home, and our Mi Preferred partners following shortly. The Redmi 6 will start selling on Mi Home, on Mi.com and Flipkart, with offline channels Mi Home and Mi Preferred.